Good morning, sir. Good morning, Paul. Good morning, Samuel.
Hello Dazza.
Good morning, Pongs.
Good morning to everybody this morning.
To everybody, because I got an announcement to make.
Oh, okay. Goodness. Oh, let me guess. You're singing on another Hope for Haiti song?
Yes. Here we go. Simon Cowell's phoned you again.
No, I've got it. Simon Cowell has asked him to replace him as the new Idols judge.
That's it.
No. This is bigger than that.
No way.
Yeah, it's bigger. It's bigger. Okay. Bigger.
Okay. Oprah wants to interview you.
No.
Oprah wants you to take over her show.
Exactly. Yeah. Yes.
Oh, really?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. No. I got a big announcement.
Okay.
I got engaged last night.
You're kidding me! I did. Yeah, you popped the question. Finally.
I did. Yes, finally.
You are kidding me.
Yes. Yeah.
Awesome.
Well done, boy. And well done.
Did you say yes?
Yes.
Okay. That's a relief. Let's sit down now.
Contrary to what every woman thinks, they say, you know she's going to say yes. There's always that doubt.
A little bit of doubt in the back of your mind, thinking, what happens if she goes no? Tell us. Come on. I feel like a girl. Detail. Okay, yes. Tell us. Where were you first?
Okay, so 6 o'clock last night.
Yeah.
I sent her an SMS. She was with me at the house.
What, saying, do you want to marry me?
Awesome, eh?
That's
awesome. Original, eh?
SMS is charged as standard rate. T's and C's apply.
No, okay. I sent her an SMS.
Yes.
And I said, we were both downstairs. She was watching TV. I was in the office/studio. Yeah. I said, go upstairs, get dressed, very smart. You have 1 hour, no questions. I'll be waiting at the door.
Wow. Okay.
So then she comes running to the office. And I said, what was the last line of the SMS?
No questions. Yeah.
So there she goes. And then we drove, and I took her on a bit of a wild goose chase because she said, where are we going? And coming from the south, we were on the M1, and she says, we're going to Melrose Arch. I said, no, because we missed that turn off because I took Jan Smuts before that. Then she says, we're going to the zoo. Yeah. I said, no.
I love the way she went.
Dress smartly
Melrose
for the zoo.
Yeah. Oh, the zoo.
And then we pulled into the Westcliff.
Okay.
Very nice.
Okay.
You're
classy, right? This is going the right way.
Yeah. And then we get there.
Yeah.
Now it's Sunday night.
Right.
And it's empty.
Okay.
But there's one other table that I've pre-arranged, pre-booked, sitting at that table.
Yeah.
And mom.
No.
Okay.
None other than the Parlor Tones.
Wow. This is her favorite group.
This is her favorite band.
Okay.
So I've organized with Khan, and I've organized with Glenn and the rest of the Parlor Tones. I said, okay, guys, this is what I want you to do.
Okay.
So now they're all sitting there eating. And I'm like saying to them, hey, fancy you guys should be
here. Pulling you out there. We're coming for dinner and you're actually here.
And now she's never actually met them, you know. And so she was like, do you think I should go up to them and tell them how much I love their music?
Aww.
And I'm like, babe, you know, come on. You know, don't act like that now, you know. So they have I'm watching them. They have their starters and stuff. And then I send Glenn SMS to Q. And then out from underneath the table comes all the equipment.
Yeah.
And they start belting out this tune in the restaurant. Worship all the fallen stars. And they've literally taken it over. And now the restaurant is filled up as well.
Okay. And these folks just start playing.
And belting it perfectly and loudly. The chorus will make sense.
Now, at this stage, are the other tables all looking around?
All looking.
What the hell's going on here?
All looking. And they're all singing this to her.
Oh, beautiful. You are all beautiful. So now at this stage, what is she thinking? Because now you've got the Parlor Tones dragging their instruments out and starting to play. She must have thought something's happening here.
Yeah, I think she thought something was happening. And then I said to the guys, okay, then, you know, do the entire song.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to pop the question. Yeah, yeah. And she was so overwhelmed at this stage. And I went down on a bended knee, as every man has to.
Yeah.
And I popped the question, and she was just finished. She didn't even give me an answer.
Oh, so wow.
I didn't even put the ring on yet.
Has she given you an answer since then?
Yes.
I just wanted to make sure that everything's not in limbo here.
Did she cry?
Unbelievable. Oh. Uncontrollable.
Did you cry?
I did.
Yes! I did.
Yes! And then I asked her the question. I put the ring on and everybody clapped. The restaurant went wild and it was fantastic. And then, you know, the Politans, what I love about the Politans, about Glenn and Khan and the rest of them, they got such a fantastic sense of humor, because after this whole thing had died down, then they said, okay, we got one more song that we want to play for Samantha. And they played this song. Was a giant mistake.
Was a giant mistake.
And I said, come on, guys, come on, man.
Give me a break. You could have played Push Me to the Floor.
Yeah,
come on. Great. Hey, well done, Whackhead. Whackhead is officially engaged. Have you set the wedding date?
Yes, 25th September.
25th wow. of September.
24th. You're all invited.
Don't say that, because you'll have 1.5 million people arriving at the wedding.
Yeah. And you know what I discovered?
What?
I'm the last one out of the group.
No.
I'm the last one to get married.
No, there's one more.
Oh!
My wingman is gone.
That means that Joffers is the last one on the team, officially.
Well, you know what, Joffs? You've got the Peri Peri Cruise, and maybe your ship will come in, my brother.
It's a big ship.
It is.
I've got a choice of 1,600.
Joffers, boy. Hey, Darren, congratulations.
Thank you.
On behalf of the team, on behalf of the entire audience, congratulations to you and Sam.
Thank you.